What's good? Welcome back, YouTube. This is your boy, SOG. Welcome to this video where I am going to be comparing the Canik Mate MC9 versus the Glock 19 Gen 5. Starting with the price point differences between the Glock 19 and the Canik Mate MC9, the Glock comes in at about $620 to $630 versus the Canik Mate MC9 that comes in at about $400. So you will find the MC9 slightly cheaper than you will the Glock 19. In terms of magazine capacity, Glock gives you 3 15 round magazines for this, and Canik gives you 2 magazines for their MC9, one which is a 12 rounder and one an extended 15 rounder. The Glock's overall size is 5.04 in height, 7.28 in length, and it is only 1.34 inches in width. And when we compare that to Canik, Canik has a height of 4.52 inches, a length of 6.1 inches, and its width is only 1.12 inches. So obviously the Glock is slightly bigger than the Canik. When we compare them in weight, the Glock comes in at 23.81 ounces and the Canik comes in at 21.27 ounces. Now comparing barrel lengths, the Glock has a barrel length of 4.02 inches, meanwhile the Canik has a barrel length of 3.18 inches. And this is what they look like here side by side in comparison. Now with the sights that you get from Canik, you do get blacked out rear and a big white dot up front. These are not night sights, but they are metal sights. So these are very nice sights, very easy to get on target and hit your shots. And these are Glock sights here. They are plastic sights and not night sights. All right, now being that the Glock is an MOS, obviously you can put a optic on there, and the MC9 is optic ready, so obviously you can put an optic on there. One thing that is nice about the MC9 is that you don't need like an adapter plate. You can actually mount your red dot or green dot directly onto the slide, which is always preferred. On the Glock itself, they do offer some adapter plates, or you can buy aftermarket adapter plates in order to fit whatever red dot or green dot you want on their slide. Now both Glock and Canik give you different size back straps for your gun so that you can basically adjust them to your grip size. Glock does a great job of continuing their stippling here from the OEM back strap. And the nice thing about Glock is, if you guys can see, they give you like almost nothing of a beaver tail. It's not completely flat, but you just barely you just get a little bump back here. But if you were to put one of these on there, I mean, you get a ton more beaver tail versus how it comes stock. So that's really nice of Glock to do, is to give you the option if you want that beaver tail. With Canik does a great job of also adding their texture on their back strap, but you don't get the option of a beaver tail, and this is completely flat. You don't get a little bit of nothing back here. So I mean, you just got these on here to help with the grip size, but you don't get an added beaver tail like you do with the Glock. In terms of light mounting options, you do have a 1913 rail on this Canik MC9, so you can practically just put anything that fits on that rail. And likewise on this Glock right here, you can fit all sorts of lights in there, so both are compatible to mount basically whatever light you want on there. And comparing the trigger from the MC9 to the Glock 19, here's the Canik MC9. It's got a very, very short reset, extremely short, very nice, audible, crisp. And here's the full trigger pull here, so you have that much play, and then you got the break. Very, very nice trigger. And here is Glock's trigger. It's also got a really nice reset. This is factory, not the Glock Performance trigger. The reset is a little bit longer than Canik's, but it is very nice. Here is the complete pull. Now it feels like it's got less of a take up than the Canik, but more mush, as you guys can see there. And then it breaks. Still a really nice trigger though from Glock here. Another thing to note on Glock's trigger is that it has this iconic feature of it where it locks back once you're on empty. So it does not allow you to continue to pull that trigger once you have shot your last shot, unless the slide is back into battery. But if it locks back, if you don't have too high of a grip and it locks back, your trigger will also lock, And that is a feature that does not come on the Canik. Some people like it, some people dislike it, but it comes with the trigger. So just that piece of information for you. Another nice feature that the MC9 has is a loaded chamber indicator, which is this tab right up here. And basically what that does is when you slap a magazine in and you rack the slide, this tab will pop up and let you know you got a round in the chamber. It also has a striker indicator in the back here. You probably can't see it very well, but it's right here. So when you rack the slide, it will pop up saying, hey, I'm ready to be engaged, I'm ready to go. You've racked the slide back, you got one in the chamber, pull the trigger and you're good to go. So it does have that nice feature, and the Glock unfortunately does not have a loaded chamber indicator, nor does it have a striker indicator. So that is another nice feature from Canik. Both the Canik MC9 and the Glock 19 are good for left-handers. So if you're out there and you're left-handed looking for a good gun, the MC9 and the Glock 19 are both good guns, good choices. Why? Because they both have ambidextrous slide stop levers. And even though the magazine release is set up for right-handed people, you do have the option to flipping it and putting it over on the other side so that it fits you better. So if you're left-handed, either of these two options will work great for you. Going into the way to disassemble these, they're basically about the same. So if you look at the Canik, you obviously want to make sure you have nothing in the chamber. You want to make sure that your striker indicator is not active. Otherwise, you will have to disengage it. No magazine. Like I said, we are clear. Basically, what you do is you just kind of pull back on the slide and you push down on this tab here and on this tab here at the same time. And that will release the slide when you push forward. And then you just kind of remove the slide from the frame, and now you have those two. And to remove the spring, recoil spring, you just pop that off, barrel comes right out. So it's very, very easy to do, and basically to reassemble, you just kind of put everything in backwards. Now, to reassemble this is a little tricky though, because Canik has this thing where if you start from way over here, now you're hitting this and now you're stuck. You're gonna end up with this, right? Now you can't even pull the slide off the frame. So what do you do? You basically pull this, the trigger safety bar, right? You kind of pull back on it like this, and that lets you free up your slide. So what I do is I put it all the way up here. You have these two tabs here. Instead of lining it up with the two tabs here, you kind of set your slide. You got to make sure that you're flush on the front too. And then you go just like that. And now you're good to go. Now, disassembly with the Glock is the same exact thing, although the tabs for the slide lock are a little bit more of a nuisance. They're a lot smaller, so they're a little bit harder to get a grip of, especially if you got bigger hands. But the process is the same. Kind of pull back just a little bit, pull down on both sides, slide goes forward, that slides all the way out. Same deal with removing the recoil spring and the barrel, and installation is the same. Just kind of basically work your way backwards. Now this one to assemble is basically the same, but this is a lot easier because you don't get that slide that gets stuck. So you just kind of match up the two tabs, go all the way back, and you're back in play. All right, so what comes in the box on the Canik? You get a holster, you get a magazine loader, you get two magazines, as I stated before, you get a punch, you get cleaning utensils, two back straps, and a toolkit. And for the Glock, you get two back straps, 315 round magazines. You get a locking cable and some adapter plates to mount your red or green dots. Before we wrap up this video, I did want to bring up a big topic, which is reliability issues, problems, concerns, anything like that that could affect these two weapons, and maybe your choice if you're looking at purchasing one or the other. So the Canik MC9 came out about a year ago, just under a year ago, and it came out with three main issues. The first issue was it failed to return battery, and it was a failure to feed issue. Now the cause of those two was the feeding ramp not being polished enough and the recoil assembly spring. So if you reach out to Canik, they do replace those two items for free, or if you send it in, they'll polish that feed ramp and then replace the recoil spring assembly. The second problem that the Canik MC9 had was that the magazines were not dropping freely from the frame. If you send it in, Canik will broach the frame for you. That way your magazines fall out freely. Otherwise, there has been a home remedy that you put painter's tape around the mag, slap it in there, heat the frame up for, you know, some time, let it cool down, and then once you remove the tape from the magazine, it should fall out freely. And the third one was a concern about this being drop safe. So I actually made a video regarding that, so I'm not going to get into that, but I did want to let you guys know that there was also that concern. I'll put a link up to that video. There's actually a part one and part two, so I'll put links up to those two so I don't take up too much more of your time here. But getting into the Glock 19, I mean, there's not too much to say about this. This has been one of the most trusted and reliable handguns in the world for years and years now. I just started becoming a Glock fan maybe a few years ago, so I don't know when they first launched if they had any issues or what generations had issues. I think the fourth gen, this is a Gen 5, I think Gen 4 had some issues if I'm not mistaken, but I don't know if it applied to the Glock 19. Now, some of you guys who know Glock a little bit better, you guys can feel free to chime in on the comments and let people know. But as far as the Glock 19 Gen 5, it has been an absolute beast. I love this thing. It's been 100% reliable. I've never had one issue. Shoots everything I throw in it, and it does it very, very well. So nothing to report negatively on this one in specific, this generation. Not because I'm a Glock fanboy, but just because I never experienced no issues with it. And that's all I can really report on, right? So is I never had issues with this one. This one I had just a couple issues, but they were addressed, they were fixed by Sentry Arms or Canik, and now it's been flawless. And I love this gun, man. I love both of these guns. So there you guys have it, man. I hope that you guys learned something from this video. But until the next one, you guys, y'all have a blessed day. Take care.